to remain. The riff is
let's do it.
Just two teams remain. They are battling their way toward this title. Game two of the finals. Hi, everyone. This is Kevin Hart.
All right, let's go.
Alongside Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. You look at the right.
Oh, I didn't mean
to hold a one game lead in the series.
Let's go. Let's restart us off.
Going on the road.
There's definitely a little more pressure on the home team at the start of a series, guys. But if there were any jitters, I think they got them out of the way with that win in game one. Now all of a sudden you win another one, you go up 2-0, and you've got a great chance to win it all.
Yeah, I mean, talking about pressure, winning this game would have
all right, give me that.
On the road with
give
very
me that.
Little of it on them. Games 3 and 4 won't be nearly as nerve-wracking if they get it done today.
Let's check out Chicago's starting lineup. Inside, Gibson and Noah. Butler and McDermott pulling out the perimeter. And it's Heinrich in at the one. Lock at 6. And the shot's good for Mr. Moves. Mr. Moves got his second bucket of the night.
They can't afford to give him that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you got to fight over the top of that.
They get the rebound. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession. Houston has come out of the gates quickly. A big win for them coming off a strong game on Friday.
Yeah, in that game, Kevin, they did damage in all sorts of different ways. They were pretty much unstoppable offensively.
Yeah, it was showtime, Steve. They showed off every resource they had at that end of the floor.
Now Butler, after the missed three for Mr. Moves. 11 feet away, shot is good off the back rim.
Let's
and
go.
That's a nice job of getting the ball in the paint and burying the shot. That's exactly all right. How it's done.
From 13.
Out of 4 from the floor, so a good start for this club.
Outside Butler. McDermott with the screen for Butler. Noah with a screen on Ariza. Back to Butler. Just 5 to shoot. Passes to McDermott. Jacks up a 3. Dwight Howard grabs the board.
Aren't dropping yet. They've missed 4 of their first 5 shots.
Harden, no good.
Oh, that went in and out.
Making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, he had a really good look. I mean, he'll knock that down more often than not.
Heinrich. All alone. And he gets it to go.
Oh, come on.
And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Here's Mr. Moves, and it's Houston with another. So it's Chicago now. It's a 5-point game. Heinrich kicks it to Noah. Gibson the screen. McDermott dishes to Butler. Pass to Heinrich. 5 on the clock. Puts it up from 12. Another one.
It was almost like he was surprised to be that wide open, yet he knocked it down.
Corner shot, and Houston
called exceptionally well as they've built this.
All right, 5-point lead. Let's go.
Bulls trail by 5. They get a hand on it.
Oh, give me that.
Fast break. Here's Mr. Moves, and he caps off the fast break with a monster slam.
Let's go.
That's the kind of play you just do not want to give up defensively. You lose the possession and give up a quick 2 at the other end. That's losing basketball.
And especially when you can't afford to give up any buckets, that pushes this lead up instead of going the other way.
Butler goes in.
Pretty good defense there. I mean, that's a shot that he can make, but they really challenged him.
Here's Mr. Moves, guarded by Heinrich. They double him with Noah. Mr. Moves passes to Jones. Just 5 on the clock. Houston needs to get a shot. Ariza
hit that.
The open look. Misses off the right iron.
Great look. Disappointing result.
You know, most times he knocks that one down.
1:41 left in the first quarter of the game. Butler against Ariza. misses in close.
Yeah,
he was
Let's
right
go.
There, but the defensive pressure forced that miss.
Well contested. That really made it a tough shot.
The shot's good for Mr. Moon.
Let's go.
This is a tremendous solo run he's on. I mean, the kind we've seen him have so many times before.
Houston, a whole new five on the floor. So Chicago is making some changes here. Here's Mr. Moon.
4-point lead.
He's got 15.
Terrence Jones, I can handle a 4-point lead right here.
And Ariza out on the perimeter, and it's Mr. Moves in at the point. That's the five for Houston right now. So it's
You jumped. Oh,
well,
there you
now
go.
They're just going to town on.
Yeah, you'd think these defenders would have done a little more to put a stop to that stuff, Kevin, but so far, no go.
Well, a phenomenal aerial assault there, fellas.
Now here's Heinrich. He's got six. McDermott, no one.
All right, let's go.
The kick outside to Butler. And the Bulls with another miss.
Oh, it happens. He's wide open, but just couldn't get it to go.
Here's Mr. Moves. And he's good on the three ball. And it's a 9-point Rocket lead.
Well, you can't leave him alone.
Let's go.
From long range.
Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
And let's now go to the sideline. We'll catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Hey, Kevin. Mr. Moves in that last game against the Bulls delivered quite a performance. He had 64 points and was just on point from deep, sinking what seemed to be an endless stream of threes. It was a performance for the ages and one that will have the whole league talking.
Great, Doris. Thanks. Any chance we see him top that performance of Clark here tonight?
I'd say no chance, partner. And that's not a knock against him. It's just that he was so good that night, I don't think he can possibly do it two games in a row.
He was Kelloggian. Is that a word?
We can there we go.
It is now.
Well, look at Steve. He didn't like that, though. Look at him.
Let's just say he was
10-point lead.
Good.
Bulls trail by 10.
10-point lead.
Heinrich outside.
We're in game two.
Noah with a screen for Heinrich.
Huh? Yeah, it's a 10-point lead. I said it was a 10-point lead.
Heinrich kicks to McDermott.
They get it back. Oh, so far this team has not been as good as the Thunder.
Here's Mr. Moves. Three-pointers off
the mark. Come on, that should have went in.
Chicago's gone 1-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for that. Heinrich kicks to McDermott.
Man, I came this far. I ain't going back at this point. No.
Heinrich's got 9. For Houston, they've gone 5 of 11 from the field since the beginning of the second quarter. Mr. Moves passes to Howard. Here's Mr. Moves. That's good. And so
there we go.
The assist. Mr. Moves got the lead up to 10 now for the Rockets. Bulls have gone 4 of 8 so far here in the second quarter. Noah with a
we can win this and take a 2-0 series lead.
He dishes it to McDermott. He kicks to Gibson. Shot clock at 6. McDermott dishes to Heinrich.
Oh, he's making that ass suck, didn't you?
I mean, his second quarter has been even better than his first, and that was pretty good.
Here's
again, little mid-range jumper.
Kevin, he's definitely making his presence felt here in the first half. He's been very effective so far.
Huh?
You ever actually had that?
I've had it on the Xbox before. No, just not right now. I might tomorrow for my Resident Evil 5 DLC stream.
McDermott kicks it to Noah. The jump hook will not go.
You suck. Let's go.
It's leading by 9.
You know, with the time left, they can trade 2-for-1 here.
If they hurry.
Yeah.
Shot's good for Mr. Moves.
Boy, they are as hot as can be from mid-range. They're getting run off that three-point line, but they're taking advantage and knocking down those middle-range shots.
Steve, they've banged home 8 of their last 10 points on pull-up jumpers.
Now here's Butler. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Here's Mr. Moves.
There we go. Take that long, too. Let's go.
The position they're in right now, thanks in no small part to the show that he's putting on in this period.
Butler sets a screen for Heinrich. The pass to Butler. Gibson with a screen on Harden. And Butler, here we go. And again, Chicago.
Even that board. Oh, we're at
halftime. Halftime in this one. Houston on top. They lead by 13. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by.
This Bulls team has been very underwhelming so far.
Okay, listen. This game is going to set the tone for the rest of the finals. And
I heard that game has a cliffhanger ending, though. The Dragon Age games.
Some fantastic numbers.
I heard this game's got like a cliffhanger ending.
And he's hit the mark twice from three-point range as well.
Well, it's no secret. I mean, the more points he can come up with from out there, the better off they'll be offensively with their spacing.
Third quarter action getting rolling right now. Brought to you by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor.
Oh.
So the Bulls five right now. Inside.
Why do we let Doug McBuckets out there getting
out the perimeter? And it's Heinrich in at the point guard.
Wide open. Oh. Oh, I was on the glass.
So the wing on the left. And another shot. The rebound by Gibson. Bulls trail by 10. Outside Butler. Jones pulls it down. Jones has got his fourth rebound in this one. Harden the pass to Ariza. And some nice passing there by Houston.
Let's go.
Shots good for Mr. Move.
I'll take that. 13-point lead.
Poured in today and put them in a terrific position heading into the stretch.
Heinrich dishes to McDermott. Pass to Gibson. McDermott with the screen for Gibson. He feeds it to Heinrich. Kicks to Butler. And it's Chicago scoring again.
Coach,
Seraphins checked in. Here are the NBA's top scorers during this postseason, as shown on the 2K leaderboard. Well, you look at Mr. Moves, leading the league in points per game. Such a great player. Bulls trail by 11. Heinrich with it. Now defended by Mr. Moves. Gibson with a screen on Hart. Gibson setting a pick for Butler. Back to Heinrich. Now here's Butler. Let's the three fly. And a great assist by Heinrich.
Oh my God, he got so lucky. I had a hand in his face.
Single digits for the Bulls. Houston's gone 3 of 7 tonight from three-point territory. Jones trying to get open. Another miss by Houston.
No.
For Chicago, they've gone 3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Feeds it to Butler. The dish to Seraphin. Tipped away. Here's Mr. Moves, guarded by Heinrich. Wasted no time on.
Let's go. 10-point lead.
Now 33 points for Mr. Moves.
They don't need much of anything else.
10-point lead.
Heinrich up top. He's got 12. Outside Butler. McDermott with the screen for Butler. Pass to Seraphin. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Oh, come on.
Bulls shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game. That free throw good from Seraphin. Houston with a big group substitution here. Kuvis checked in for Howard. Tolliver comes in for Terrence Jones. John Salmons, he's checked in for Trevor Ariza. And it's Cannon in for James Harden.
Let's go. 11-point lead.
Mr. Moves.
What a competitor, Kevin. He's been looking for a shot all game long, and he's really shouldered the load for them offensively.
Heinrich kicks to Seraphin. Over to the left wing. Here's Knox. It's rebounded by Houston.
Give me that board.
Mr. Moves got 4 rebounds in this game. Here's Kanan. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
Well, probably the right play defensively. If you can't get the block, send them to the free throw line. Don't give them an easy 2.
No easy buckets inside. Force free throws and work to keep them out of the lane next time around.
We've gone about 3.5 minutes into the third now.
Why do the Bulls have two number 21s on their team?
And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
Some good play tonight for Heinrich. He has 12 points and he's put one three.
Coach, what are you sending me out for?
I like it.
Behind the arc.
Coach.
43 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Mirotić sets the screen for Heinrich. That's good. The Houston lead is cut down now to just 10 on the basket from Knox.
Well, the pick worked really
what is
well
this?
There. Nice job taking it right to the 10 for the layup.
Houston in for John Selmans. And a change for the Bulls. Noah's checked in. And he's good on the second.
All right. Well, we got an 11-point lead. Let's go.
Heinrich outside. Had a chance there to cut it to single digits, but it's off target.
It's a plus five advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady work they've been doing on the interior, no question. And that's, I think, the main reason they have this lead. Yeah, nice fast break from start to finish, guys.
Here's Mr. Moves. He got it up that time, but it wouldn't.
Come on. Okay, 9-point lead going to the fourth quarter.
Welcome back to our coverage of the NBA Finals. More action straight ahead. While we have the chance now, folks, let's go to our State Farm assist of the game.
I was hoping we'd get a chance to see this one again. Thank you, Lonnie, and the truck for showing it. But it's passing like this that makes the basketball purists happy. This is the beauty of the game right here.
Terrence Jones is down low with Howard. Harden and Ariza out on the perimeter.
Hit that, Ariza. Let's go. 11-point lead. Right now.
Here's Butler. Noah with a screen for Butler.
The streak will continue.
Design on the pick play, and he lays it in.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but their cutting, their movement together as a unit that's led to that.
The shots.
Let's go. 12-point lead.
Manly performance here. He's hit 2 3-pointers in each half now.
1 minute now into this fourth quarter. Now the feed to Butler. Passes it to McDermott.
Okay.
Snell dishes to McDermott. Inside. That's good. The Houston lead is cut down
come
to
on.
Just 10 points on the bucket from Snell.
He's doing his best to carry him, fellas, but he can only do so much. Things would be different for them if he was getting a little more help.
The double team.
Ariza. Hit that, Ariza. Bang.
That's two bombs in a row from long range.
13-point lead.
Shoddy defense there. Far too slow to react on the closeout.
McDermott with it. Pass to Bump. The 9-foot shot. Rebounded by Howard. Howard's got rebound number 5 here tonight.
Such a solid.
Go, Ariza. Oh, there we go. 15-point lead.
Yeah, that's just one of the few things that have gone their way today.
Screw this. Screw out this lead just to make sure
They'd love to get more of those. The easiest 2 points.
You heard me. I'm
a fierce finish.
Yeah,
I'm not even going to repeat that.
Cut into the lead, Kevin.
Yeah, that's why they've got to tighten up their D. And I'd be surprised if the defense allows any more free runs to the hoop like that. Now he's playing with an edge here, playing extremely well offensively here in the second half.
Kirk Heinrich, he's checked in for Chicago. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Well, guys, Tom Thibodeau had some advice for his team in that last timeout. He was definitely not pleased. He said, "You guys look lethargic out there," and told them they've got to increase their
activity
level.
Someone invited me to their party. I can't right now.
Get the job done. I want to see
maybe another time.
Now, here is Harden after the miss from Joakim Noah. He was all alone on that one. Mr. Moves got 43 points.
Well, he continues to light it up. He's the leading
scorer. Okay, something tells me that this.
Now here's Heinrich. Defense right on him. Makes it off the glass.
They've got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
Probing them?
The job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guys.
Here's I don't know what you're going to listen to this nonsense yet. I'll say, okay, I wouldn't put it past 2K if y'all seriously... If Ronnie 2K actually made you say some of that dumb stuff.
Now here's Heinrich. Dishes to Butler.
I'm not really a game developer, so I wouldn't really know.
Shot clock at 6. And it's Chicago scoring again.
He is pouring it on in the second half, guys. I mean, a much better showing than he had before the break.
They double him with Noah. Reza passes to Mr. Moves. And again, the Rockets good for
Let's
two.
Go.
He has really put his foot on the pedal this quarter, doing a tremendous job leading their offense.
Heinrich outside. He kicks it to Butler. Noah with a screen on Hart. McDermott with it. He's picked up by Ariza. McDermott dish setting the pick for Butler. And it's Chicago scoring again.
Wasn't able to get his name in the score sheet in the first half, but he looks like he's starting to find his comfort.
Heinrich on the double team. Mr. Moves passes to Howard. Ariza has the open.
Hit that Ariza.
They get the rebound.
Boy, just by his body language, Kevin, you can tell he thought that triple was
okay.
Fall.
I'm pretty sure we got the win right here.
After that miss. That'll effectively take care of game two here in the NBA Finals. We'll be switching venues for the next one. But right now, an important win for the Rockets.
Looking at both these teams, they're great rebounders, and on any given
Let's
night,
go.
You might not know who would have the advantage on the boards.
Yeah, but they did a better job tonight. They made the most of the extra rebounds, too.
Well, you look back at this one, and what an amazing performance this has been for Mr. Moves. Now, there wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every opportunity he got.
Here's Heinrich following the basket by Dwight Howard. To the middle.
Go, Harden.
Finish line.
You know, once they
a 35-inch vertical for that, huh?
Killer instinct came right out.